James Fletcher Hamilton Henderson Jr., one of the most influential arrangers and bandleaders who helped bridging the gap between the Dixieland and swing eras, was born in the small town of Cuthbert, Georgia, in 1897. His parents worked in education and they greatly contributed to his musical development. He started receiving piano lessons from his mother when he was just 6 years old, which would also include his younger brother later on. It is said that his more demanding father would occasionally lock him in his room, where he had to practice playing the piano for hours at a time. Despite clearly having a musical talent, Henderson moved to Atlanta, Georgia at the age of 18, where he studied mathematics and chemistry. Around that time he also gave up his grandfather's name James, and he became Fletcher Henderson. After receiving his bachelor's degree in mathematics and chemistry in 1920, Henderson moved to New York City to continue his studies towards a master's degree in chemistry. He also took up a part-time job as a lab assistant for a downtown Manhattan firm. Henderson shared an apartment with a fellow pianist in New York, and his roommate's misfortune started Henderson's career. When his roommate fell ill for an extended period of time, Henderson sat in for him to play the piano in a riverboat orchestra on the Hudson. Soon thereafter, he was hired as a permanent replacement. Fun fact, Henderson met his future wife, Leora Mayo, there. They married in 1924, her name is often misspelled Mayo, she played the trumpet in the orchestra, and she was a notable musician herself. Through his contact with the Riverboat Orchestra, Henderson also got a contract as a song demonstrator with the Pace & Handy Music Corporation. Pace himself was an Atlanta alumni, like Henderson, which might have further benefited him. In any case, Pace had Henderson join him as a music director when he created Black Swan Records in 1921, apparently the first record company owned by African Americans. By then, Henderson had fully transitioned from chemist to musician. In 1921 and 1922, Henderson toured with the Black Swan Troubadours, featuring the famous singer and actress Ethel Waters. But besides Black Swan Records, he also recorded with Columbia, Paramount, and Edison up until 1923. 1924 was the first time that Henderson assembled his regular recording orchestra for public performances. They became the house orchestra at Club Alabama, and they performed at the Roseland Ballroom. The orchestra was off to a good start, because it already featured Don Redman, who was mostly playing clarinet and saxophone back then, but he was also arranging for the orchestra. Redman later recalled in an interview, "We decided to make Fletcher the leader because he was a college graduate and presented a nice appearance. This might seem an odd reason nowadays, but this made sense back then when racism and segregation were still social norms, and the band did have a strong interest in performing at high-paying white clubs." Later in 1924, Henderson also brought Louis Armstrong on board. Needless to say, this was a great win for the orchestra, even though only for a short time, because Armstrong returned to Chicago in 1925. In 1927, Don Redman left the band to John McKinney's Cotton Pickers as musical director and leader. Nevertheless, Henderson's orchestra continued recording with various labels, sometimes performing under Henderson's name and other times as the Dixie Stompers or Connie's Inn Orchestra. Times were hard though. Henderson suffered a shoulder injury in a car accident in 1928 and the stock market crashed in 1929. Despite support from producer John Hammond and musician and bandleader Benny Goodman, who bought his arrangements, Henderson had to disband his orchestra in 1934. Luckily though, Hammond had introduced Henderson to Goodman, so they all knew each other, and Henderson simply joined Goodman's orchestra as a pianist and arranger in 1935. Henderson tried to make comebacks with his own orchestra a few times, but he never achieved another breakthrough. He also toured with singer and actress Ethel Waters again in 1948 and 1949. Unfortunately, his career as a pianist came to a sudden stop when he suffered a stroke with resulting partial paralysis in 1950. He still worked hard on a comeback with arrangements and rehearsals, but he finally passed away in 1952. He simply collapsed in the street. Henderson might not have felt that he had achieved much during his lifetime, but his arrangements really advanced swing as its own genre, and his music is still being played today. A museum has been established in his memory in Cuthbert, Georgia, where he grew up, and his birthplace home, the Fletcher Henderson House, has been added to the National Register of Historic Places. His wife Leora passed away in 1958.